Hello, everyone. We are talking with Pooja Kiran, Dr. Pooja Kiran. And the topic for today's discussion is herbs for men's sexual health. Welcome, Dr. Pooja. And let's just get started with herbs for men's sexual health.
Thank you very much, Amita. And welcome to everyone who is watching the show. So today's topic is herbs for male sexual health. Now, although many people might not know about it, but a lot of men do suffer from various problems of reproductive issues, including low sperm quality or no sperms, or ejaculation problems, and even mental stress that causes them problems in reduced sexual performance or nervousness. So today I'm gonna discuss some herbs that can improve some of the conditions, including low sperm count, ejaculation capacity, and overall an improvement in mental and physical health that contributes to various causes that can cause problems in male sexual health. So the first herb that we would discuss today is shariva. The English name is Indian sarsaparilla. Not many people might know about this herb. It's a very common herb in Ayurvedic medicine, and it is widely used in the treatment of oligospermia. That means low sperm count. So it is cooling in nature and balances all three doshas with special effects on vata and pitta. I would like to include, I would like to tell everyone that mostly the reproductive issues of males are related to vata and pitta. When there is aggravated vata or when there is aggravated pitta, that causes a lot of problems. So the herbs that we are going to talk about are mostly that balance vata and pitta and increase kapha. So this property helps in improving the sexual health in males. And shariva, this herb has it mitigates vata and pitta, and that helps in improving low sperm count, and it is also known to improve sperm quality and quantity. The second herb is a very common herb, very popular, known as ashwagandha. The English name is Indian ginseng. In Sanskrit, ashwagandha refers to the smell of a horse because its root has a strong odor resembling that of a horse, and is believed that it may impart to men the strength of a horse. So it is known to possess beneficial properties to alleviate male reproductive disorders, including increased healthy sperm formation, improved blood flow to the reproductive tissues, and regulated endocrinal hormonal functions. It relieves conditions such as spermatoria, which means low sperm count, nocturnal emission, premature ejaculation, and enlarged prostate. It is one of the best herbs for balancing vata and pitta and acts as a great aphrodisiac. Owing to its stress relieving and relaxing effect on the mind and body, as well as its fortifying effect on all the tissues, because it is considered as a rasayana as well. That means it helps in rejuvenation of all the tissues. It is considered the best herb to target many of the contributing factors that are associated with reduced sexual energy in men. And the best way to take ashwagandha is the powdered form of ashwagandha mixed with milk and taken at night. The third herb is shilajit. This is again a very popular herb. It's actually not a herb, it's a mineral. The English name is asphaltum or mineral pitch. It is a derivative of a certain rock, a Himalayan rock, and it is a mineral of that rock. So shilajit is immensely important Ayurvedic herb, which with its heating energy increases virility and sexual stamina by balancing vata and removing excess kapha while maintaining pitta. Now, in kapha-related reproductive imbalances in men, it is used in combination with ashwagandha, and it is excellent for people who suffer from diabetes. The next herb is bala. The English name is flannel weed. So bala refers to strength in Sanskrit, and being a rejuvenative tonic herb for vata and pitta, this herb finds application in nourishment and strengthening of all body tissues, especially the muscle, plasma, bone marrow, and reproductive tissue. So as the name says, bala, which means strength, it strengthens all these tissues. So the properties as per Ayurveda is sweet, heavy, and oily in nature, and is also mildly cooling in nature. So bala is one of the best anti-vata herbs in Ayurveda, which mitigates disorders related to both body and mind. It plays a leading role as an Ayurvedic herb in the treatment of chronic fatigue. So a lot of causes could be indirect in terms of the male sexual health. It might not be directly related to the reproductive tissue, but it could be related to the mind. It could be stress. It could be fatigue. So many factors are considered when we recommend a certain herb or a combination of herb for improvement of sexual health. So bala is a very good herb that is used in combination, especially in case of chronic fatigue or exhaustion in men. And that helps in rejuvenating the overall health and in exhaustion of physical and mental strength. It serves as a tonic to restore sexual strength. It promotes spermatogenesis, which means it helps in improving the sperm formation. And it also overall enhances the male fertility. So it's one of the herbs that's given in combination for treating male infertility. The fifth herb is Kapikachu. The English name is cowhage. It's also called Atmagupta. It is a sweet and bitter tasting herb and is heavy and oily in nature. And it is mainly used to balance vata and pitta. This herb has been studied and shown to improve sperm formation and ejaculation. The seed extract of this herb showed marked improvement in sexual potency and behavior, libido, other sperm parameters, and even endocrine levels, including testosterone levels, and was proved to be effective in improving semen quality. So sometimes the problem is not with the sperm, but with the semen. The semen might not be viscous enough. It might be too thin, and the sperms are not able to swim in it properly. Or there are lots of other factors like that. So Kapikachu helps in improving semen quality. So that is another herb that helps in improving male fertility. And the final herb today is Vidarikanda. The English name is alligator yam. This is a starchy tuber and is effective in promoting spermatogenesis with faster action when taken as a milk decoction. It works better when taken as a milk decoction. You need to warm it up, or especially like boil it in milk, and then take it as a decoction. You have to reduce it to 1/4. So there is a process of taking this herb. Its efficacy is more when taken as a milk decoction. Its combination with Kapikachu is effective in treatment of enlarged prostate. So that is another reason of male infertility. There might not be any other problem in semen or sperm, but there could be enlarged prostate. And because of the enlarged prostate, the semen is not ejaculated, or there is a blockage that causes the sperms not, or the ejaculation not to happen, and that can cause infertility. So Vidarikanda helps in treatment of enlarged prostate. This herb promotes ojas, also called the vital energy. Again, it's people who have a lot of exhaustion or chronic fatigue or less strength in general. As this herb promotes ojas, it helps in improving the sexual performance. It improves in the muscle tone. It helps motor coordination. So all these factors are important. So there is a motor coordination from the brain to the tissues. So sometimes that coordination is not there because of some kind of a neurological problem or spinal problem, you know, a lot of factors are taken into consideration when a certain process is going on in the body. There has to be a motor coordination. Some people have problems, neurological problems, which might deter the process to happen naturally. So Vidarikanda helps in that. And it nullifies sexual debility associated with nervousness and adrenal stress. Adrenal stress is, again, it's related to the adrenal glands that are situated on top of the kidney. So they secrete adrenal hormones. And when there is stress, these hormones get affected, and it can overall cause nervousness. And then, again, it hampers the performance. So so this herb can nullify that nervousness and adrenal stress when used in formulation with ashwagandha, because ashwagandha is very good for stress relieving properties. And it falls right between being too warm or too cooling. So it's like neither too heating nor too cooling. And that's why this herb provides a great value as both a vata and pitta balancing herb. So as I said in the beginning of this session, that vata and pitta are the main doshas that need to be balanced for improving male sexual health. So Vidarikanda, again, is a vata and pitta balancing herb, and that in Ayurvedic terms helps in improving the conditions. So these were the six herbs that we discussed today. It's very brief description of all these herbs, but when taken in the correct form, especially I would suggest that before taking any of these herbs, it's always best to have a discussion or a guidance of an Ayurvedic physician, so that they can you know, guide you as per your natural constitution, as per they go through each and every aspect of your daily life regimen, diet, lifestyle, stressors. So they are you would be able to find the right combination of herbs and how to take them in the correct manner. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Pooja, for being with us every Sunday. Well, from next Sunday, we are going to be discussing with a completely different topics, and Dr. Pooja will be talking about Panchkarma, so, you know, detoxification. So stay tuned, and we'll see you next Sunday again. With that, thank you so much, Dr. Pooja.